Like I said, just got my new crap in today, putting it in right now, but let me show you guys something, okay? Let's see what I'm dealing with. This right here is a normal wiring harness out of the back of a, just, you know, regular aftermarket radio. Just plugs into the back, and these plug into your car, okay? My new radio, this is what I'm dealing with. Get up here so I can get to all this. Look at this crap. I mean, that's a handful right there, son. Alright, these are all auxiliary inputs, outputs. It comes out of the back of the radio, goes through here, goes into a noise dampener box right here. You got a hot wire or a fuse here, and I thought, yeah, and a fuse here. And then this goes down to the pigtail, which goes into my car. So if that right there is not a set of wires, I mean, look at this thing. Here's the radio, and look at there, there's one, two, about 2.5, almost 3 links of wire, hand links of wire coming out. If I stretch them out, it'd probably be 4. That's what I'm dealing with. Got the dash ripped out. You know, wires freaking hanging everywhere. But, so we're going to get this puppy in here, and hopefully next time you see this, it'll be in full function operating mode. So, you guys hang in there. This is Bigfoot, new car audio installation. Here we go. We got her in. Give her a check out here. Pretty freaking sweet, if you ask me. Look at that illumination. Perfect color blue, you know what I mean? I mean, this guy's, he knows what's going on. So I got my Bluetooth on for my phone. Just get out of this real quick. Now this, I had this thing in here like 5 seconds, so haven't really mastered it, you know what I mean? But I mean, it sounds wicked, you know? It's sweet, man, you know what I mean? And it's even got this feature, which I really like about it, that it actually shows you right there, Hot 102, you know, on your little screen there, boss. I mean, this, for $100, I mean, you know, this thing is originally like $500, okay? But I paid $169 for this thing on eBay, you know what I mean? And, I mean, for what it is, I mean, it's a wicked, wicked deal. Well, see, I can't figure this thing out. What are you doing? Oh, that's like a scan feature. Okay, cool. You know, like I said, I've had this for, like, not very long, so haven't really figured it out. Well, I'm trying to, oh, crap. I'm trying to get back to my menu there, so, let's see, I forgot how to do it. Oh, yeah, and it's got a adjuster here that you can adjust the screen to whatever you want it, but that's as far as mine goes, because I don't know if you can see that, but I can't even get my finger in there. It's like perfect fit because my knobs for my air conditioner kind of sticks out a little bit, and but it's perfect, you know what I mean? And it's right, I mean, the screen comes up to level with the top of my speaker. You know, see, my crap's ghetto where I've had so many sound systems in here and taking this thing off so much it's loose, but my vents are perfect. It's not going to blow heat on the back of the monitor. It's not going to get it hot. Back to what I was doing. Oh, you can change the soft and sharp and standard and bright, but I like it right there. That also adjusts your screen. Crap, man, I don't know how to get back to it. That's the mute. What's this do? It ejects your CD. Another mute button. PTY, don't know what that is. V. There you go, 102. AFON, don't know what that is. I gotta read the book on this thing. But anyway, if I could figure out how to get back to the screen, this thing's got GPS on it and everything. So $169. I mean, it's not bad. But, you know, that's my new toy, y'all. I'm fixing to put in the amp. I'm gonna smoke a cigarette and chill out for a little while. And then gonna restart the course. But, I've had it running for a while with the key backwards. But anyway, gonna go put in this amp and, you know, maybe shoot another video and, you know, show y'all what's up. But, my poor little CB there. I'll clean his car. I'll clean it when I get all this crap in here. But yeah. Anyway, there it is, baby. Looking sweet. There's my fuse block right there. And I need to get some ring terminals, better ring terminals. Here's my old power wire, which I'm gonna still use to run my linear. Here's my new power wire. You can see them side to side. It's quite large. It's run through there. Actually got lucky on this part. Run it through there. And right here into this rubber grommet where your door speakers and crap comes in, I run it through there and under the door. I mean, it comes out right there. But if any of you guys has ever put in a 2-gauge wire in a freaking car, it's hard to hide a 2-gauge wire. I mean, this thing is massive. Here's my old puny little ground wire that went to my other amp and is now upgraded to this big bad boy right here. Here's my old power wire, still run to my linear, like I said, AUA auxiliary, or that's the jumper to my linear, base knob, auxiliary, power wire over there. Run into a fried capacitor and into another fuse box, and then the blue wire into the amp and the gray and all that crap. But, so there's the bad boys going in there. So that's where I'm at. I'll get the rest of this hooked up and get back with you. Guys, here we go. Finally got everything put back together. Car's a freaking mess. I got crap all over it. I need to clean it out with all the new install. But here we go. Got the fried capacitor, like I said, you know, to run in 2-gauge. Got the, you can't see that, but it's a 200 amp fuse. I could have cut the hot wire and shortened it up, but I really didn't want to because I'm probably going to buy that truck and stick it in there, so, which this system would be awesome, but like I said, 5,500 watt boss, which is quite a large amp. You know, it's like half my freaking back seat. That's that set up, and like I said, I got my tools and wires laying everywhere, but I've got my head unit. And anyway, let's shut this door so we don't piss off the neighbors, and give you a little run.